Rhode Show Kitchen, we are cooking with Napolitano's Brooklyn Pizza. Christy Flanagan joins us. You are owner and chef, correct?
That's correct.
She does it all. And today she's also going to be making cheese and meatball calzones.
Yep.
Man, sounds phenomenal. What do we need for this recipe?
We're going to have some mozzarella cheese, mm-hmm. a little bit of meatballs, homemade, ricotta cheese, garlic oil, mm-hmm. kosher salt and pepper, and we serve it with a side of gravy, and we'll need some dough.
Okay, great. And you said the meatballs you make in-house. How about the dough, too?
The dough is made fresh in-house. The meatballs are made homemade, mm-hmm. and then we pull the gravy from the meatballs.
Oh, nice. You're working with all the best stuff. Now, for people who aren't familiar with where you're located, where is Napolitano's?
100 East Street in Cranston.
Okay, and you were claiming, too, that you guys have the best pizza in Rhode Island. Why is that?
Hands down, we have the best pizza in Rhode Island. Mm-hmm. New York pizza. We're from New York, born and raised.
And you're bringing it over.
And we make everything fresh, everything the right way. Calzones mm-hmm. with ricotta cheese, mozzarella cheese.
Yum. Yeah. And we are going to try some of them today. We are going to get started in just a little bit. 20 years experience in the kitchen, zero for me. So we'll see how that kind of balances out a little later in the show. We're going to get this going in just a bit. Back to you.
All right. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Christy Flanagan's here from Napolitano's Brooklyn Pizza. We're making pizza. And you know what? Just the smell of this pizza that you already have here. I'm like wanting to dive over and grab a piece. What are we going to do now to make this pizza?
We're going to make calzones today.
Okay. All
actually.
Right. Yep.
So start out with some fresh dough. Mm-hmm. Room temperature.
Okay.
I'm going to keep it covered so it doesn't dry.
Okay.
I'm going to have you roll the dough.
All right.
Last time you cut the cheese, this time you're going to roll the dough.
You do what you can. All right. How long does this dough have to sit out to actually make it easy to work with?
About an hour.
About an hour? Okay.
Until it comes to room temperature.
All right.
But it depends on the outside temperature.
Okay. So I'm just going to roll this out. And how big do we need to get this so that we can make this?
A little bit.
A little bit bigger?
Bigger.
Okay.
So
is this,
put some flour.
Is this crust going to be thin around this calzone?
It's pretty thin.
It is pretty thin,
yep.
Okay.
All right. It's pretty thin.
All right, so we're rolling this out.
Yep. That looks pretty good.
And calzones, you can put anything in it. What do you guys serve?
Traditional calzone, New York calzone, is ricotta cheese, mozzarella cheese, and that's it.
Okay. of which, as luck would have it, I love.
Oh, great. In our ricotta cheese, we put a little bit of garlic oil, give it a little special flavor.
Right.
And we run it through the RoboCoop, so we kind of like a food processor, so
right.
it gives it a little smooth texture.
Okay, how am I doing over here?
You're doing good. You're doing good.
All right, so I'm gonna roll that out nice and thin.
Yep, looking good.
Make that even. And this is something anyone can do at home. It's pretty simple to do, right?
Yeah.
All right, so we'll roll this out. We'll put everything in just a little bit, and then we'll throw it in the oven, right?
That's right.
Okay, good stuff. It smells fantastic here in the Rhode Show kitchen. We are gonna put everything together. In the meantime, back to you.
Awesome.
Christy Flanagan is here from Napolitano's Brooklyn Pizza. We're making meatball calzone. We have the dough already rolled out. We had to roll it to a thin crust, thin to put everything in. And what do we need to do right now?
Now we're going to put the filling in.
All right. This is the best part.
So start with cheese.
Okay. And what kind of cheese? What kind of cheese are you going to use in here?
This is the shredded mozzarella cheese.
Okay. Put some of this in here.
Yeah.
All right.
And we'll pass that
over to you.
And put a little cheese.
Are we doing this one too?
Scoop of
toss that in, sure. Just a scoop. All right.
Do one more scoop. Yeah, there
Sounds
you go.
Good to me. Okay, put that in.
Switch.
All right.
Well, you got it.
This
gotta
is why I'm already
I'm
not
I'm
sticking
not
to
really
my New Year's resolution, because we're putting cheese
and meatballs.
And now, any of these meatballs, what do you use to make your meatballs?
Ground beef, eggs.
Right. So traditional, traditional way.
We fry them, hand fry.
Got it.
And then we cook it in the tomato.
Okay.
Ooh, sounds delicious.
Put that in there. And about just a couple in each, although you could load it up with whatever you wanted, I guess.
Yeah, anything you want.
All right.
Anything you
Everything
want.
Smells so fresh.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's all fresh.
Okay.
All right, and then what we do is cover this up.
Okay. All right, so am I going to cover it this way?
Yeah.
Oh, this
just
one?
Pull it forward.
Okay.
All the way
through?
Yep.
Okay.
And just give it a little pat.
Just
kind of seal
intact.
Everything in?
Yep. And then
Look
you
at this. Not
this.
Bad. I'm actually impressing
seal
myself.
You want to seal it?
I will seal it.
Good job.
Multi-use.
Not bad, huh?
Multi-use.
You're very proud. All right. So we seal that in?
Yep. And then we cut it around.
Okay. Now, you were saying a lot of your family is from Brooklyn. All your family's still there, right?
Yeah. Everybody's still in New York. Okay. Just me here in Rhode Island.
All right.
So this is a true sort of New York
traditional.
This is a true. Ricotta cheese, mozzarella cheese is how we do it.
How
in
we
New
do
York.
It. All right. So you got to put
this
in?
And then, very important, you need to make a little hole.
And this is just to let the steam out, right? Okay.
Yep.
All right, to vent out the steam.
Yep, and then we put it on our pizza peel.
All right, now are we preheating this oven too?
Yep, you do the oven to about 450.
Okay.
Put a little flour.
I need to put enough holes in this thing. Okay, there we go. I don't want the thing exploding in there. Not on my watch anyway.
No.
All right, so put that in.
Now,
do we have to put any butter on this or just as is? Just going to let it be as is. Okay. I know a lot of sometimes you put a little butter on top, you know, to make it glisten a little bit, but
that's
we're just going to throw it in this way. Okay. So the oven's on 400.
Comes out.
Oh, yeah. It gives that toasty
look
instead of the glistening.
Yeah. It actually has a look of almost like one of the pita pockets, the top of it. Put that in. And how long are we going to let this sit in the oven for?
It takes about 15 minutes to 20 minutes, depending on your oven.
This is a recipe that anybody could do at home that, you know, you could do tonight. You could make it for the family tonight for dinner, and you could whip it up quick. Or if you have people coming over, this would be something that you could do.
And you can make them ahead of time.
You can make them ahead of time,
too. Right, put it in the freezer. I was thinking that.
Good.
It's a good idea.
And serve them up in the oven. All right, let's cut into this, see what we got. While you're at it, tell everybody where your restaurant is.
We are located at 100 East Street in Cranston.
Oh, look at that. Wow, we. This whole New Year's resolution thing is nuts. We're an hour into this, and I'm already doing.
There you go.
Will's New Year's resolution was to lose weight this year. So
Say
just exercise. You can still
maybe
eat it.
Start
it's delicious.
Tomorrow.
Yeah, maybe we'll start tomorrow. Maybe we'll wait till the 3rd. All right, so cut this in. You can put anything in. You chose meatballs. You chose ricotta cheese and provolone cheese. But anybody home, if they want to add spinach, they can add any of these, any of the things.
Add anything into it. But the regular New York calzone is cheese.
Okay, is cheese.
Mozzarella, ricotta cheese.
So if we want to stay traditional, this is the way we have to
make. And then we just added meatballs.
And then we just added meatballs in. All right, perfect.
A little extra.
And then you dip it into the sauce, right?
Yep.
Okay.
And dip right in on the
sauce. I noticed that.
All right, very good. It looks fantastic. I can't wait to try. Yes, I'm going to have a little bite. Absolutely. If you want this recipe, you can head to our website, WPRI.com.